Good morning, students. I'm Sister Clara. Today let us begin from your first chapter, from the Beehive, The Fun They Had by Isaac Asimov. Isaac Asimov was born on 2nd January 1920 in Russia. His family moved to the US when he was a toddler. Asimov was a prolific and varied writer. Apart from science fiction, he was also known for writing books on astronomy, biology, mathematics, religion, and literary biography. He died at the age of 72 in New York City on April 6, 1992, from heart and kidney failure. The present story unfolds the picture of future schools, where the mechanical teacher will teach the students and books will be meaningless. As you see in the picture there, you see schools of the future. There may be virtual classrooms. There are learning through computers. And the teacher will be the robotic teacher and the moving e-text. Learning through computer as you are doing these days. The students will learn only from the e-books and the class test will be conducted online. The internet will have wide applications and the subjects like history, geography, mathematics will no more be difficult for the students. They will get the hard books only kept in the library. Of course, this future school will be quite different from our present school and the old school. The story, The Fun They Had, deals with a boy and a girl, Tommy and Margie. Tommy, a 13-year-old boy, and Margie, 11 years. They find out something about the school of the past. On May 17, 2157, Tommy finds a real book in the attic, which has been printed on paper. Tommy and Margie both take a look at it. The words were still. They were not moving. This book was about schools. The book is really old and pages were yellow and crinkly. By the year 2157, this kind of books will not exist anymore. That time, words will move on a TV screen. These TVs can contain over a million of books. That is why Tommy thinks that they are much better than the old schools. He says that the book is about school, but Margie hates school and she does not understand why someone would write about it. She is having problems with learning geography from her mechanical teacher. It is black, large, and has a screen on it. It teaches the students, gives them exercises, and asks them questions. It works from in a special room in her own house. It can also calculate the marks in no time. Margie hates the slot where she has to insert her homework and the test papers. Once the geography sector of the mechanical teacher was too quick, so she got worse marks than before. Tommy says that the book he has found is not about their type of school. It's about the school of the centuries ago. Excuse me. He finds the students in the past as a real man, as a teacher, who taught the boys and girls. He gave them homework and asked them questions. They had a special building and all children went to school. All of them learned the same thing. First, Margie could not understand how a man could be a teacher, and nor could she understand how every student were taught the same thing. Her mother says that education must fit each child's mind. But in her opinion, those schools were funny and she wants to read more about them. However, Margie was thinking about the kids of those old days, about the fun they had in school, laughing and shouting in the schoolyard as you all do, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day, helping one another with the homework, and talk about it as they learned same thing. And the teachers were people. After all, he says, they had a teacher and it was man. And at the end, Margie is happy with the school of past days, past times, that they had a teacher and it was a man, and they all learned the same thing at the same time. I hope the summary of the story is clear to you. You will find on page number 10 some questions. They are very easy. Read the text properly once, twice till you understand, and try to write the answers from the textbook questions in your own words. Let us discuss some of them. You see, the first question: how old are Margie and Tommy? I told you already, Margie was 11 years old and Tommy was 13 years old. Second question: what did Margie write in her diary? Answer would be, Margie wrote in her diary, "Today, 17th May 2157, Tommy found a real book." Third question: had Margie ever seen a book before? No, not at all. Margie had never seen a book before. This was the first time that she was seeing a book. Fourth question: what things about the book did she find strange? Answer would be, the book had yellow and wrinkled pages. Why they were yellow and wrinkled pages? Because it was very, very old. You remember, the situation is placed in the future. It's in a futuristic story, that is 2157. And so these books were yellow and wrinkled. And the words of the books were still. They were not moving. And like as she was used to in the computer screen, she found these things very strange. What do you think a telebook is? Fifth question, you see. Answer would be, a telebook is displayed on the television screen and the text of a telebook is similar to a book. Sixth question, where was Margie's school? Did she have any classmates? Answer would be, Margie's school was near her own bedroom. Next room, attached to her own bedroom, was the classroom. And she didn't have any classmate because each child studied from their own houses. Seventh question, what subjects did Margie and Tommy learn? Margie learned geography and mathematics, and Tommy learned history and mathematics. The second part, you see, answer the following with reference to the story. First question, I wouldn't throw it away. Who says these words? Who said this? Margie says these words. To whom? To Tommy. What does it refer to? Here, it refers to the real book that Tommy had found. Third question, what is it being compared with by the speaker? The speaker compares it with a telebook. Second, sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man. Who does they refer to? Here they refer to the people of the old times, his grandfather's time. Remember that. What does regular mean here? Answer would be, here regular refers to the mechanical teacher then they had. Third, what is it contrasted with? It is contrasted with a normal teacher of earlier times who was a living human being. The third part, you see, answer these questions about in short paragraph, about 30 words. What kind of teachers did Margie and Tommy have? Answer would be, I'm sure you know it, they had a mechanical teachers. They were taught on computers and television screens. They didn't have a living person as a teacher who would teach the pupils in a classroom. Second question, why did Margie's mother send for the county inspector? Answer would be, Margie's mother sent for the county inspector because the mechanical teacher was not functioning efficiently. It had been giving her test after test in geography and she had been doing worse and worse. Third question, what did he do? The county inspector. Okay. He slowed down the mechanical teacher's speed up to an average 10-year level, though Margi was 11 years old. Okay. The mechanical teacher's speed was controlled and adjusted according to the IQ level of Margi. What is IQ level? It's an intelligent quotient. Fourth question, why was Margi doing badly in geography? What did the county inspector do to help her? Margi had been doing badly in geography. This was because the mechanical teacher was very fast in displaying the questionnaire. The county inspector adjusted its speed up to an average of 10-year level. Thus, the mechanical teacher's speed was controlled appropriately. The county inspector assured that the overall pattern of Margi's progress was quite satisfactory. What had once happened to Tommy's teacher? Once Tommy's teacher was taken away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely, which means his computer had gone for repair. So Tommy had nothing to do during that period. He only relaxed and enjoyed, and he wished that often it should happen. Sixth question, did Margi have regular days and hours for school? If so, why? Yes, Margi had regular days and hours for school because her mother said little girls learned better if they learned at regular hours. And therefore, students, you also should set up regular timing for studies. It's a good habit. You should habituate yourself. This time I have to study and this subject. That helps to remember. Seventh question, how does Tommy describe the old kind of school? Tommy says that the old schools were different. They had a special building and all the kids went there to study. They laughed and shouted in the schoolyard. They enjoyed time together and learned lessons together in the classroom, and they went back home together enjoying on the way. Eighth question, how does he describe the old kind of teachers? He says that the old teachers did not live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. They gave homework to students. They were not mechanical teachers, but living human beings. And the fourth part is your essay type questions. You read the lesson once again and then write it in your own words. I hope the lesson is clear. Now it is your duty to learn the lesson and the question answers.